Right, so the South Wales Derby, the biggest derby in Wales and one of the biggest in the UK.
So two sets of fans that really hate each other and are passionate and massive rivalry.
So Ben Wilmot was the unlikely hero the last time the Suicides met at the Liberty Stadium, as his goal proved to be decisive in Swansea's 1-0 victory over the Bluebirds.
No team itself resembled the derby over each other.
So all the pressure is on Cardiff as they're home.
Will the pressure get towards Cardiff, or can they rise to the occasion?
Or can the Swans claim victory in what would be the first double of all time?
They've had the best of times, they've had the worst of times. These two Welsh cities, one built on copper, the other coal. 38 miles separate them geographically, but culturally and mentally, it's a whole different story. Cardiff, the capital, the heartbeat of business, culture, media, education and government. The city that voted no, but got the Assembly. Swansea, the city that said yes and got nothing. The Assembly and the Ayatollah, the Swans and Swim Away, the Bluebirds, the Jack Army, SA1 or Brains SA. Swansea Bay, the Mumbles Mile, the Gower, Dylan Thomas's ugly, lovely town. Cardiff Bay, the Millennium Centre and Millennium Stadium. The Liberty Stadium, Catherine Zeta and John Charles, Shirley Bassey and Charlotte Church. The FA Cup, Cardiff have won it, they've even hosted it. The top flight, Swansea stormed it.
What a shot!
And very nearly fell out of the league altogether. John Toshack the player, or Tosh the manager? Ivor Allchurch, Alan Curtis, Robbie James, Cliff Jones, Nathan Blake and Ernie. It's City versus City, a tale of two. The best of times, the worst of times. It was the season of light, the season of darkness. It's the season for South Wales derbies.
So there's not long left now. Can Swansea claim the double, or will Cardiff stop the party?
Will it be repeat, or will it be revenge?
We will find out on 12th of January.